See the lighting change behind me and when tears from her eyes. She shook them away so angrily that some salty water splashed in Polly's mouth. "Stop standing there staring at me, can't you?" she said. "Go upstairs and play." There seemed nothing Polly could do but climb the stairs to her room. There, Nina was busy setting out a tall, steep party. Polly could taste salt still, but she pretended not to notice and sat on her bed and opened her letter. It was typed like the envelope, but not in an official way. Polly could see mistakes in it all the way down the first page. Some crossed out with the right words written above in ink. Some crossed by typing slanting lines and "sorry" typed before the right word. The paper it was typed on was a matte mixture, all different sizes. The first page was smooth and good and quite small. The next page was large and yellow. Case like the crossed off ones, I'll read as the wrong word because he corrects himself, so you'll figure out what he means. And the other ones, I think I'll just pronounce the word correctly, but I'll leave this here. So hopefully you guys can see that. "Dear Polly, after I had to run away so abruptly, sorry, suddenly, I had quite a while to sit on the train and think, and it seemed to me that we still had a lot of details to settle. Chamber pots. window of the supermarket has a huge hole in it, with notices about this week's prices flapping in shreds around it. As Mr. Piper races up, a white deep freeze, which makes more sense than a deer being in a supermarket. Through the hole and crashes into a parked car. Dozens of pale pink frozen chickens drop like bricks and skid across the road. People scream and scatter. Rears Zeb was coming back around the corner, uttering She put the letter down into an envelope and addressed it carefully. She went downstairs with it, intending to ask Mom for a stamp from her handbag. But since Ivy